Chapter 4, Section 3 deals with writing equations in point-slope form. Point-slope form is defined as an equation in the form of y minus y sub 1 equals m times x minus x sub 1 in parentheses, where m is a slope and x sub 1 and y sub 1 is a given point on a non-vertical line. You can see this listed here in words, the same thing that we've just said to you. And in symbols, you write it as a formula, y minus y sub 1 equals m times the difference between x and x sub 1. And you've got a graph right here that shows you how you could apply it. You notice you have your x sub 1 and your y sub 1, or your red and your blues, which they plug in here, and your other unknown x and y points are out there. So to write an equation in point-slope form for a line that passes through 3, negative 2, with a slope of 1/4, and then graph the equation. First thing we're going to do is we're going to plug in what we know. We know what our slope is. Our slope is listed, our slope is listed right here as 1/4, so that goes in for the slope value. And then we have our x sub 1, which is 3, going in for the x sub 1. We have our y sub 1 minus 2 going in for the y sub 1. From there we get to do some simplifying. I'm going to next go off and make my ugly problem pretty, and negative times the negative became a positive. And with that we now have our equation written in point slope form. We can use this to plot a point on the graph at 3, negative 2, and then use the slope to find another point on the line. Draw a line through the two points, and then you're going to have your graph. So first off, we've got the point 3, negative 2. That's the point right there, 3, negative 2. And the slope is 1/4. A rise of 1 and a run of 4 gave us another point. Connect the points with a line, and you've just graphed the equation. So all you need to graph an equation is to know where one point is and know what the slope is, and then you can use a point-slope form of the equation in order to graph the whole thing. Easy math. Anybody can do this stuff. Here's another problem. It says that if you are given the slope and the coordinates of one or two points, you can write the linear equation in the following ways. First off, you can take and substitute the value for m and let the x and y coordinates be your x sub 1 and your y sub 1. Or you could substitute the value for m and x and y into the slope-intercept form and solve for b. If you solve for b, of course, that would end up giving you your y-intercept, and you could rewrite the equation as needed to get it into that slope-intercept form, and using your y-intercept and your slope, you could then graph your equation. Or you could take, if given two points, find the slope first, and then choose one of the two points to use, and with that, you can follow the steps in writing the equation and follow the steps for writing an equation given the slope and one of the points in the point-slope form. Either way is a very good approach to solving the problem. Let's take a look at this one. We were given y minus 1 equals negative 2/3 times the difference of x and 5. It is currently in point-slope form, and it wants it to be written in standard form. Now, if you remember, standard form is where we had a to the x plus b to the y is equal to c. We need to take this equation and change it so that we can get it into standard form. First thing they wanted us to do is use the multiplication property of equality. And the reason we did that is we don't like having the fractions in here. So instead of having a fraction, we want to have a whole number right here. By multiplying both sides by this denominator, the 3, we're going to be able to take and get rid of that fraction and have a whole number. So we use 3 on both sides using the multiplication property of inequality to eliminate the fraction. In doing that, you ended up with 3 times y minus 1 on the left, and over here, these 3's canceled out, leaving a negative 2 times x minus 5 on the right. That's, of course, substitution. We can use our distributive property, distributing the 3 through the left and the negative 2 through the right. And after that, we're going to start using some addition and subtraction properties of equality. They took an added 3 to both sides. They did plus 3 and plus 3, which canceled these out, and 10 plus 3 was a 13. And then they took and added 2x to both sides, giving you a plus 2x and a plus 2x, canceling these out, leaving 2x plus 3y is equal to 13, and you are now in standard form. All you have to do there really is use your distributive property, eliminate fractions if you can, use your distributive property, and then isolate to where your x's and your y's are on the left with a positive x value in the front, and then your constant is on the right. Easy math. You can also use this approach to find the y-intercept of an equation and rewrite the equation in slope-intercept form. Once again, we're going to go with a nice equation in the point-slope form. Y plus 3 equals 2/3 times the sum of x and 1, and we're going to change that into slope-intercept form. They took their original equation. Real quick, let's go back and look at what slope-intercept form is. Remember, slope-intercept form is y equals mx. Whoops, I miswrote that. I'm talking and writing two different things. Mx plus b. That's the format we want to get it into. So in doing this, we're going to take and, there's a 2 in the denominator there. I wonder if they use a multiplication property to multiply both sides by a 2 to get rid of that. Nope, they didn't. This time they just used the distributive property. And I can understand why, because we're going to want to keep the slope as a fraction. So there they took and they gave us 2/3 times x is 2/3 x. 2/3 times 1 is, excuse me, not 2/3, 3/2. 3/2 times 1 is 3/2, using the distributive property. And now we got to take this 3 here and get it to that side in order to get us in the y equals mx plus b format. So from there, they took an added 3 to both sides. And let me show you how that worked out, because it looks like they just changed a sign there from a positive to a negative. They didn't. They had 3/2. Minus 3, otherwise known as minus 3 over 1. Find your least common denominator. It says 3/2 minus 6 over 2. 3 minus 6 is 3. You leave your denominators alone. Sign in front of your larger number went in front of your answer. And that is where that negative 3/2 came from. So there you have it. You're in slope-intercept form now. Y equals mx plus, or in this case, minus b, because a minus is just plus a negative. So y equals mx plus b, y equals 3/2 x minus 3/2. That is your answer. Easy math. Here's a new approach. Let's take a look at this. Geometry. The figure shows square RSTU. Okay, we can all see that. Write an equation in point-slope form for the line containing TU. So this line right here is what we want in slope, point slope form. To do that, really it's not going to be that hard. We're going to take, find the slope of TU. That's easy. We got a rise, 1, 2, 3, and a run, 1, 2, 3. So 3 over 3, otherwise known as 1. So, or we can list it as slope is equal to y sub 2 minus y sub 1 over x sub 2 minus x sub 1, which would be the better way to show your work. Plug in your values for your x's and your y's, and you found what we just showed, that the slope was equal to 1. From there, we can use that to put it in point-slope form. And we can use either point for the x sub 1 and the y sub 1. I could use the u point, or I could use the t point. It is entirely my choice which point I use. In the end, it'll all work out the same. So in doing that, we got your point-slope form of the equation. You just found the slope. That's going to go right here in the M spot. Your y sub 1 and your x sub 1, that was your choice. Did you choose u or did you choose t? Let's see, the textbook chose to use point 2 and 4. So let's see, point 2 and 4, they chose to use the u value because the u value is 4, 2, and that's what they have here. Your x is 4, your y is 2. Now we're going to take and, of course, use our substitution. Why do they do that? Oh, they're saying that you could have used the other points as well. So if you'd use one point, it would have ended up like that. If you use the other point, it would have ended up like that. And in doing that, you will have answered the question. You will have written an equation in point-slope form for the line containing TU. Both of those equations are valid answers. Either one, because it says you only write an equation. So if you wrote this one or if you wrote that one, it would be a valid answer. You may end up on your test having the question to write two equations in point-slope form if you end up having a question like this. Part B says write an equation in standard form for the same line. So now we're going to take either one of those and put it in standard form. Remember, standard form was a to the x plus b to the y equals c. That's your standard form. So we're going to take and do that. They chose to pick the first equation, and in picking the first equation, they use their distributive property, distributed the one through it, and then they use their addition property of equality, adding 2 to both sides, which gave them y equals 1x minus 2. Then they use their subtraction property of equality, subtracting 1x from both sides. Subtracted 1x here, they subtracted 1x here, and that gave them negative 1x plus y is equal to negative 2. But we've got a little issue here. We're almost in standard form, but as you recall, your a value cannot be negative. We cannot have a negative a. So to get rid of that negative a value, we're going to take and multiply both sides by negative 1. What they did is they went times negative 1 here and times negative 1 there. And in the end, negative 1 times negative 1 became a positive 1x. Negative times a positive became a negative y. And a negative times a negative became a positive 2. So that in standard form, your equation is going to be x minus y is equal to 2. If you chose to use the other equation to do this, it's going to work out the same. Take and use your distributive property. There it is. From there, we're going to take and point it in point-slope form, addition property of equality, adding 5 to both sides, subtraction property of equality, subtracting 1x from both sides, and then multiplication property of equality, multiplying both sides by the negative 1. And lo and behold, what do you get? Well, we got a slow computer. There it is. X minus y is equal to 2. Once you put it in standard form, you get the same exact equation. Even though we started with two totally different looking point-slope forms of the equation, because they dealt with the same graph, the same line on a graph, in standard form, they were identical. Your homework is page 236, 11 through 42 odd, and 59 through 75 odd. Don't worry about this. Justify each step. But I do want to emphasize something. Right now, we've learned three different forms of this equation. You've learned the slope-intercept form. I know I'm not writing real pretty here, but that's okay. The computer's not really playing nice with me. Come on, give me that E. Oh, there it is. Slope-intercept form. You've learned the point slope form, and you've learned standard form. You're going to have to know all three of these. You've got to be able to know if I say to change it to standard form where you're going to. If I say change it to slope-intercept form, you've got to know what you're going to, because you can't get it there if you don't know where your destination is. You can't arrive at the train station if you don't know where the train station is.
The Trunk Monkey, the revolutionary idea you'll only find one place. Suburban Auto Group. Mm-hmm.